Hello everyone. Welcome to the English analysis of the CLAT 2020 paper. We all know that yesterday the CLAT committee released the answer key, and the answer key challenge time is until 12 a.m. 12 a.m. as in on the 29th of September, right? So, so you have until 12 a.m. to challenge this key. So we will be going over each and every question and see if there is any problematic question. Also, I will be happy to explain to you the answers to questions. There might be certain ambiguities around some questions, so we will discuss them along the way. Now, the first passage that we have here, as you can see, is on climate change. And I have marked in red all the key sentences that went into deciding the answers of the questions that follow, so that we have a better understanding of where the answer is coming from. And as you can see, this passage, the central theme starts from the part which I have marked in red. That is, vulnerability to climate change is not just a function of geography or dependence on natural resources. It is also socioeconomic and political dimension that decide climate change and the vulnerability to climate change as far as the economically backward society is concerned. So this is where now the central idea of the passage is, that climate change poses a threat not just to the geography and natural resources, but also a bigger threat, more of a threat to all those vulnerable societies that live in a country, especially those that bear the triple burden of social vulnerability, economic vulnerability, and political vulnerability. Due to the apathy of the government, these people are not covered whenever there is a climate variation, leave alone climate change, right? So this says they are already struggling with existing challenges of poverty and climate variability, right? This has already been mentioned. So they're already suffering here. Not to add to it, climate change could really push them beyond. So this is what the central thrust of this passage is, right? And then the author gives you solutions which follow from the sentence starting with adaptation. Adaptation is a process through which societies make themselves better equipped, better able to cope with an uncertain future, right? Taking the right measures, right? These range from technological options as well as, then the author starts talking to you about traditional methods. And then the better warning systems, improved risk management, right? All right. Then here it says that since the speed is a lot, climate change is reduced and the capacity to adapt is increased, and national adaptation methods, national adaptation plans need to be implemented. Also, communities must build their resilience. How? By including appropriate technologies and making use of traditional knowledge. And then this bit about traditional knowledge has been given here. So these are the solutions that are offered on this topic of climate change. Right, so we have read the key elements here. So this was given in the last part. What do these communities need to do? Implementation of national adaptation plans. Nowhere has the author spoken about short-term plans. Right? Urgently, what do they need to do? Urgently, this is required. Later on, of course, technological solutions are a long-term plan, but urgent requirement is of national adaptation plans, as can be seen here. So with respect to developing countries, because there is an urgency, read the keyword urgency, developing countries, these have to be implemented. national adaptation plans. Right, all these three words together, fact-based question. So let's quickly move on to the next. Select the option that contains the correct answer. Right, vulnerability of poor to climate change. Naturally, they are dependent on natural resources, can be seen from the passage here. It's not just a function of geography or dependence on natural resources. Can you see this line? Not just a function of So that means this is also included. That they are dependent on natural resources, plus climate change affects geography, and it also affects socioeconomic, etc. Factors. So let's move on to the question and see. So yes, it is not just a function of natural resources means. It is a function of natural resources, geography, both are in the same lines, lack of financial resources, lack of traditional knowledge, they have enough. The only thing that locals have to their disposal is traditional knowledge, right? All right, which of the following is against the idea portrayed in the passage? Naturally, A is the correct answer. A is the idea portrayed in the passage. That we have to, as is given in the last part of the passage, let's quickly go to the passage. Communities must build in their resilience using traditional knowledge, right? The need of adaptation interventions depends on national circumstances. Local communities have to cope, right? And together with that, we need to check overall national adaptation plans that have to be adapted. So if you combine this part here, these plans, including local coping methods, this will help us battle it out, right? So yes, that is in sync with the passage. The process of adaptation to climate change does not account. This is contradicting the third last line. Hence, it is the incorrect answer. So even if you were not sure about A, C, or D, B is the correct answer because it is contradicting the third last line, right? So whenever we have to give an answer which says against the main idea, usually one should look for an option that is directly contradicting a line in the passage, which option B is doing. So the moment you saw that, there should not have been a problem. The traditional knowledge should be used through. Now, this knowledge will do nothing to national circumstances. This is an unnecessary option. Tax, we haven't spoken about. This should be used by developing it closely with the government. This is what this last paragraph talks about. Hence, that becomes your answer. Resilience, what is the correct answer for resilience here? That whatever happens, we can adapt. The whole thing is about adaptation. Because the whole thing is about adaptation, the best word would be flexibility, right? Since the whole thing is about adaptation. So the correct answer would be C. All right, the second passage is on the boys' locker room. As you all can see, this passage is taken from the current discussion that happened during the pandemic time, during the lockdown, and talks about how in the lockdown, everyone sort of morphed into their internet avatar, and that impacted the kids also. So let's look at the main points that I've highlighted here, right? So it gives you a brief about the boys' locker room group. And then the author's main point starts from here. It is important to recognize how and from where a teenager is spouting this sort of objectification. right? And then it talks about how people morph into their online avatars and the reasons, which could be heavy involvement of technology, etc. Young impressionable minds absorbing the normalization of the rape culture. All this toxicity is something which they see as natural, right? And then the author suggests solutions. So always remember, the author's main thing comes from the solutions and the reasons the author highlights for a particular problem. These are the mainstay of the main point made by the author. These are the mainstay. So if this youthful role receives timely counseling, there can be prevention from adult offenses, right? And this has to be done by school and parents. Key point, we will use it in our answer ahead. Also, the author says that even though there is artificial intelligence, it has failed to stop all this from happening. Hence, this AI should play a more proactive role. So these are the three suggestions offered by the author. Right? So let's go and start working on the questions. What is the central idea conveyed by the author? The central idea has to be keeping in mind the suggestions of the author, which is which has to be mainly about, you know, the last three suggestions that have been highlighted, right? Now, option A has been marked as the right answer in the official answer key. However, option B is the second of those suggestions. So both A and B have been used as suggestions where we have to do counseling, we have to remove this male toxicity. So why A has been chosen as the answer and not B is something which I did not understand. So this is a question that can go up for challenge, because none of these options, or there should have been an option that includes all the suggestions given by the author, right? So, you know, again, this is one problem question that we have tried to highlight here. Now, why is this incident a wake-up call for parents? It has said that parents, if they, it has been a wake-up call because the author recognizes this as a problem. Parents have invested a lot in technology, but have failed to counsel. That's the option we have to look at, which has been given in option D. And you can also eliminate the other options easily here. All right. What has to be done in order to prevent this? So, right. So root cause of this would finally lead to the prevention of this. So prevent it, or root cause of this, naturally, the author states the toxic masculinity, which is prevalent, and timely counseling can help in removal of it. So it says both schools and parents have to counsel, and we have artificial intelligence has to be proactive, right? So if you don't go very heavily on the words here, these are the three solutions that come up as the answer options here. Hence, your answer will be option D. All right. Spouting. So closest option I would take would be pouring. Erupting is a more higher degree word, one could say. So now this all of the above option sort of is always a, you know, a tricky downhill thing. Whether you go for one very good option or you look at all of the above, if all of them are seeming to be correct. So one way which guarantees about 50% definitely true scenario is if two are convincingly there, you are convinced that two would be there and the three is okay-ish, you mark all of the above, right? That goes best in the Indian scenario examination, where we give a wide leeway to our answers, right? But if you're convinced that there is only one good option, you stick to it. So this was one of those tricky ones, really. All right. Then we come to the bit on American literature. As you can see, with our third passage, So let's look at the third one. The cat question. So here the cat has been basically compared with humans. And unlike humans, the cat does not have any constraints, is what the author has said. So that comparison should not mean to be literal, right? So it's only a comparison. And then the cat's adaptability has been discussed, right? Alongside, there is a lot and lot of figures of speech, as you can see, like, as, providence has been written with a capital P. The question on the figures of speech, is the answer is clearly out there, right? So once you read this passage, it has a very dreamy sort of quality. So providence and crescendo is the highest note that you can take. So you had to mark second option as high, right? And providence over here has actually been used as not just providence, which is luck or fate, basically fate. Here, forbidding providence has been used, right? That means ill fate. So that would be your best answer here. So they have taken it in context. So if you read it in context, that line says something about forbidden providence. Naturally, there should be no discussion. Similes and providence, which has been used, is the personification that the author has used, right? What describes the motives? The cat is hungry but does not immediately go to satisfy the hunger. Again, it is not about survival of harsh winters, it is about survival of famine. And this survival of famine, the cat does by waiting for the rabbit to come out and then nab it when the rabbit has nowhere to go. So pretty clear answer over there. Then, for he was living alone, what does the author imply here? I would have gone and done it with elimination method. Absolute freedom from everything. It is a very, very extreme option. It's not absolute freedom from everything. Cats, no association with human beings. Here, human beings are not being used literally. There is only a comparison that humans have constraints which cats do not. That is the one which is being used, right? Cat has been living alone and has no constraints, and hence the freedom to stop and wait and not be sort of tethered to any relationship. So that is the best option. And of course, this is out of context entirely. So you had to just choose from elimination what is closest to the answer. All right, let's move on to question number 15. He never faltered, never cried because he had nothing to gain from it and everything to lose, suggests that the cat is. Basically, the cat has been enduring all hardships. So this is the second usage of resilience here in the English section. Naturally, not a tough choice to make over here. All right. Again, we come to the next American literature passage. And here it is about a summer night and the author's preference for the night over human relationships as again, right? So the night is caressing, the night is solemn and it is mysterious, right? So then look at the katydids. They do not chatter like people. Because they do not chatter like people, they are wise. All these are going to be things we will use in our answers. And of course, the author's rhetorical question, what does a human know about Christ? Right? So let's look at the options now and the questions. Why has the author lost interest in human beings? Right from the first paragraph, we had marked all this in red. Because they make them suffer is given over there. Caressing, warmth given over there. We had underlined it in red. Let's go back and look it. Right, so look at this point. Literally given, they make me suffer. caressing wind and mystery and solemnity. Right? These are the preferences for one thing which humans lack. So all of the above would be your answer. The author has compared the night with. Look at this part. The author has compared the night with. Why do fools cumber the earth? It was a man's voice that broke the necromancer's spell. So the author was happy in the night, which was caressing it, right? Soothing it. And suddenly man descended the earth and broke the necromancer's spell. This necromancer's spell has to be nothing but the night. That's your answer over there. We've already discussed why are the katydids wise, because they don't chatter like humans. That is your answer here. Right, let's move on to the next question. What can be inferred from the passage? The last line, which is rhetorical. What do people know about Christ? That means all the people who break the night spell, they cannot know about Christ. They are not close to nature. That means those who are close to nature must be knowing something about Christ. So this comes in from the last point there. This is irrelevant. Nature is just a mystery. Books and man are both detestable, has been given literally over in the passage, but it is not something which you can infer. It is something which the author categorically states. So answer would be option one. And simple question of meaning from the passage, which is course. Then we come to the passage part on Graham Greene's book on this most unusual case. It's pretty narrative. That means there is a nice anecdote here. And if you read it, it reads straightforward. So bulging eyes, bulging and pecking ease eyes. So that meaning had been asked. So I have highlighted it in red, bulging and pecking ease. And steps of Mrs. Parker's house, that's where she caught the culprit. So, why was it the strangest trial? As per the author, why was it the strangest trial? Not because of the accused, but because of the twist in the end, that even though there was a witness who was very sure, in the end what happened was the witness got confused between another person who looked exactly what the witness had described as. So that was the twist that was presented in the end that could be inferred as the answer. Right? Now, the moment you see a figure of speech question, you spot a like and you know your answer is a simile. This I've already discussed. Both bulging and pecking gaze was used, so could have been done easily, right? Why was she convinced? Because when the defense asked her why she was convinced, this answer is clearly given. There was light on the man's face and the moon was out. Who was murdered? Though the steps were Mrs. Parker's, we cannot say Mrs. Parker herself was murdered. Some woman was murdered and the person was seen on the steps of Mrs. Parker. But we cannot describe who was murdered. And the final passage on the telemedicine, as you see, initially it starts talking about the lockdown and everything. And then finally, opportunity of telemedicine that is emerged. And then the whole passage talks about telemedicine and the opportunities that emerge as a result of it. Right? And you see, because of telecommunication, telemedicine gets a boost. And we are able to send all images faster, simpler, and the pilot was also successful. Therefore, you have this answer here. All right. Now, inexorable has been used right in the beginning. That means something which is bound to happen, something which will not change, something which is inevitable. So that is not a tough question to get. Best summarizes the main idea. Naturally, it is about telemedicine, right? And towards the end, the author warns us of the harmful effects of having so much data and data privacy. Both of them combined make B a better answer than A. Once you read B, I do not think you will have any problem choosing this answer. All right. Why is there slow employment of telemedicine in India? This has been given clearly in the passage due to lack of any legislations. That is given right in the middle of the passage. It's a fact-based question and you could have easily done it. It says primarily due to lack of legislations. I can show it to you also. So, let's mark it from there. But the progress has been excruciatingly slow, right? By the lack of legislations to enable teleconsultations. So this is clearly mentioned why the progress has been slow until the pandemic. Once the pandemic came, their progress was swift, right? So it's clearly given. And why would there be easy outreach? There would be easy outreach because of easier communication of medical images brought to you by telecommunications that enables us to build the potential of telemedicine. Now, this looks like a better answer than D because C is definitely not an answer. Now, easy outreach, why? Because of securing sensitive medical information. No, this is a bad fallout of easy access. Easy access results in C. So again, I do not know how D is the option. Easy access results in a negative impact, which is C, which the author has warned us against. So because C is there, we know it cannot be all of the above. A is again, because of easy communication and good technology, the pilot was also successful. So that's another step. The best answer here would have been B, is what we feel, and this can be questioned. Shot in the arm, simple phrasal usage, simple answer, positive impact, right? So I hope our analysis helped you understand why certain answers were there. And most of the answers were given in the passage. There are a couple of questions that have very dubious answers and which we have highlighted here in front of you. So I hope this was helpful. Stay tuned for the other subjects that we would be taking here. Thank you, everyone.